EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Atlanta Falcons. Here's Bosher to kick it away.
I'm probably gonna thrash it behind. Let's see. Jump. What's up?
Hi, Dad.
What you doing? Why you down there?
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Dallas Cowboys. Marr now to kick this one away.
Oh, man.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he is out of bounds here on the return.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. Taking it to the room. No, what are you doing? No, no, there's nothing up there you need.
Check, check, watch it before, watch it before.
Let's go. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Yeah, you're going to try to yeet it.
On 2nd down, Freeman.
Get in there, bro. What's up?
And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
This defense looking for an early stop. This is 3rd down and 6. From the shotgun, Ryan. Ryan hit, and he lost the football. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk-reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit,
baseball bat in the car,
and in this case, lose the football.
So, should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20/20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on 2nd down.
And some space here.
Boom.
19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. A tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the fourth overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
Showed off the juke, but still corralled shy of the 5 at the 6-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. The give is to Elliott. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it 3rd and 1.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid game. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing.
And he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. A 2-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead.
What you doing?
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Extra point by Moore, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see it.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away.
We're good, Richard.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone.
Ah.
And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That could be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
They're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down. This is Freeman on 1st and 10. He'll get about 4 as he's past the 35 to the 38-yard line. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
Let's go deep, tighten up. On 2nd down, it's Freeman.
Come on, Freeman.
Muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5.
All right, Brad, I know we're in early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. He's got Sanu. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. Ryan to Sanu, good for an Atlanta first down.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, when in doubt, find your veterans.
He used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver, but it's going to be 2nd down. An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. To throw again. Ryan. Buying time to his left. Giving it out left side to Sanu. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. And this play, it was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
Sean Lee, the Pro Bowler, there for the tackle.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And an alley to run. And he will avoid the contact as he slides to a stop. 12 yards there and a first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
The running game's played a huge part in getting him down to this point on the field. I say stay with it. Keep pounding the football. Keep driving, keep grinding.
Yeah, even down in the red zone, keep going for it.
No doubt about it. Dance with what brung you.
Now they'll throw it with Ryan. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. Leighton Vander Esch wreaking havoc with a sack.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation because the silver lining, it took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
After the sack on first down, Ryan to the end zone, but it's incomplete. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well,
too. I was talking to myself, babe.
This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Here's Ryan. Being chased out left. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Off the edge, it's Tyrone Crawford with a sack. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. So they get three, certainly hoping for six after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job there. But here's the other part. 13 plays, you don't force any mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. He's going to air one out. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Keanu Neal.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Second and five now. Ryan is going to fire one deep. Middle. That's caught inside the 20. And he takes this down deep on the Cowboys' side of the field. A big play there just before halftime. And even 40 yards.
Nobody
and
knows
he's going to find his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, got to like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
And that is caught, but the bank judge right there to say incomplete.
It's been my observation. There's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit. But he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Falcons have taken the lead.
And while that touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead, it's still a lead, and that always feels good to a team.
They'd love to take that into the lockers, but a little time left on that clock, so some work to do.
I like that. I like how you're guarding against a letdown there.
Are you looking forward?
Coaching them up from right up here in the booth.
Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away.
Bring it up.
This field at a few yards into the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not.
Ooh, I should have told you that.
So the defense there, opportunistic.
Ooh. It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times the score matters what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, let's just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
Hey, South! No game on this defense. Let's go!
The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he's not going to go anywhere as they get him down behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. We have hit halftime.
He has come in.
We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game.
What kind of rule?
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is fielded a couple yards deep.
Come here.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 26. Second half starts with a carry by Elliott. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the third. First and 10 at the 38. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. And that is incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Here's Prescott. Flushed out right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Vic Beasley making it look easy, cruising in for the sack.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and losing yardage and digging themselves a hole that they can't get out of.
He's going to look deep down the field. And that's caught inside the 35. A big play here for Dallas. 41 yards.
It's your first drive of the second half. You're down on the scoreboard. Maybe just say to yourself, let's take a shot, see if we can shake them up. And boy, they hit that one.
A first down carry by Elliott. And only able to get two here. Stopped at the 30.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's gotta be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside.
Yeah,
he's
here.
Again, Italian.
Come here. Come on, man. Why y'all gotta put all that animation on it for? That's some bullshit.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown.
Shit, at the block, you got to make that
Ezekiel
man do all
that. His second touchdown of the afternoon, and the Cowboys have retaken the lead. Mar now to add the extra point. And that makes it 14-10.
Where you come from?
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he is out of bounds here on the return.
No, we're not getting in the. We're gonna eat it. We're gonna eat lunch in the
morning. Ryan to the Falcons now. Come up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll run with Freeman here to begin the drive. He's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
From the 27.
Come on, Ryan, baby.
And he will go down. A Cowboys sack.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Mike 48. Third and long. It's Ryan. Pressure again, and down he goes again. Sean Lee, the longtime vet, getting in and getting to the QB.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Good starting position for the Cowboys here as they come up first and 10. They start on the ground with Elliott. And an alley to run. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And he's got it all the way down to the 12-yard line. A big run that time by Elliott. 41 yards on the ground. And a guy that can change the game shows you a glimpse of it right there, taking the ball down inside the red zone.
It just tells you how tough it is for a defense. You just hold on all game and essentially hold your breath. Will they break a big one on us at any point during the game? It just happened right there.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. After only a yard. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind, just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground before, they're doing everything possible to have him do it again. They need that turnover.
And he's not going to get anywhere close to the marker as he'll stop him well short of the yellow line. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll bring up fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. The kick by Maher is good. And that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. From a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll probably wish he'd reconsidered here. It will cost him 10 yards as he's down at the 15.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
They'll throw on first down with Ryan. And this one brought in by Sanu. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. The tackler almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays harder to move it.
And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
20. On second down now. It's Freeman, and this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by Leighton Vander Esch.
Brandon, offensively, this has been a tough day for him. Trying to find a place to throw the football. It's been extremely difficult. I've got to give a lot of credit to the secondary, especially the corners who've had the receivers on lockdown.
On first down, it's Elliott. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Fresh out of the locker room, they hit him with a gain of over 20.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Looking to throw. Prescott looking for the end zone. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They'll run on first down. Freeman, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of two there, second down.
Not a position where they absolutely have to rush right now, but they definitely have to pick up the tempo a bit.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Here's Ryan. Ridley. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before that one good for 26 and a first down. Obviously a big first down right there.
Yeah, they still got to hustle. They got to get up to the line of scrimmage and get set. But I don't think necessarily you need to spike it, but they've got to continue to move quickly.
58, go! Bravo!
Here's Ryan. And he Can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Defensive end DeMarcus Lawrence applied the heat. Ryan to throw. Steps away to his left. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go. Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
They'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down. They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. Ryan hit, and he lost the football. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. On first down, Elliott. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot. But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had 3 takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. Till next time, we say so long from Atlanta.
Yeah.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League comes to you from Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, Michigan. Both teams emerging from the Ford Field tunnels just a short time ago. And, of course, the loudest cheers were reserved for the hometown Lions. They're set to go as they will match up with Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 20.
Yeah. Well, you might know I'm talking. Pitching my game. They're good. Let me get one.
No. Shoot. No, wait. Get off of me my oranges. No, I'm not. Go play the game.
Go play the game. Can I please get some oranges?
2 yard line. The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 22 yard line.
The
first carry for the tailback, Devontae Freeman. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards.
Well, things are looking pretty darn good on this first drive, aren't they? Came right out, set the tone, this time with a big pass play.
And if the pick behind the curtain that they gave us for their game plan, I don't think that's going to be the last one we see.
I think you're exactly right about that. Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Let me see what they're weighing. I'm talking about, man.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Ito Smith, his first carry. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll make it third down. From the gun, it's Ryan. It's caught, Jones. Past the 20.
Everybody,
they're
going
to be set up down around the 15. On the third down conversion.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
21.
They'll run on first down. It's Freeman, and he'll take this one down near the 15. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
On second and 9.
Oh, good play, Cole.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Coleman.
Right,
he's at the 50, the 40, 20, 10, 5. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown.
Oh, nice.
Well, we know this defense has athleticism. Spots like that prove us right.
I love the way that you spotlighted the athleticism, because you and I both know the best athletes on the field, they play on defense.
Oh, I don't know. I was a kicker. You got to remember that now.
Come on. Come on.
Fine. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And following the pick six, and they have a decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this run.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told him, they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up, because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now Ryan going to give it to Freeman. That second down run, a big help. The 7 yards leaves him with just a 3rd and 3 now.
And that's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And, you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the chirping. Right now I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. We are right there about to break a big one.
It goes as a gain of 9, and it moves the chains. First down, that's the end of the first quarter. After 1-7-0, Audie Sports. Ready for the second quarter, and it's our visitors with the football as they've got it with a 1st and 10. On the heels of that good carry by Devontae Freeman, here's 1st and 10. Okay. He's going to let this go for the end zone. And that'll wind up incomplete. Try to give his man room to run under it, but it's 2nd down. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
He doesn't find a ton of space following the display of quick feet down just inside the 45. After getting stuffed on 1st down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. And the Lions going with an extra DB here on 3rd down.
You see what play time? You see what play time? Hey, check 24, wait! You don't play.
Hey, South! Hey, high 7! You
play. Hurt me.
Operating from the gun, Ryan. And Jones has it over the middle. Second down, but not before picking up the first, thanks to a flashy little spin move. Ryan to Jones, the Falcon connection there for the first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
He did.
And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman, 34 yards. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. On for the extra point, Giorgio Tavecchio. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. That So I'll leave it at 7 now as they kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Stafford and the Lions now have it first and 10 at their own 24.
Come here.
And they'll start to drive on the ground with Johnson.
Why is he, why I like to about
he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front.
Oh, yeah.
He did a pretty good job just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35.
You can't block me. Look at him.
Throwing again. Stafford.
Get there.
And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. Well, you got a young quarterback. You know, maybe that's just an example of a growing pain for him.
I think you're right about that, because when the game starts to move fast and it moves quickly on him, a lot of times they fall back on what they know best.
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted.
You go fishing, picked
up by DeMonte Casey. And he returns it into territory.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
You hear
me? After the interception, here's Ryan. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. It's a gain of 5, and it's a second down.
Now, that's the type of play that gives you a chance to win. Nothing forced downfield where you don't have a guy open. Swing it out to the back, and maybe even check it.
Get him in the middle. Come on.
Gain of 5. Come on, just trying to get 4 on first down. They're ahead of the chains now.
They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on second down. From the gun on third down, Ryan. Looking in zone for Jones.
Give him a shot.
1:58 left to play until we hit halftime. Detroit was up for the challenge through the air. They force a fourth down.
It's a cover two he doing. I'm going back, man. Good person.
Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Buying time to his left. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. They were caught in no man's land that time, but the decision to go for it, that was the right one. It's a first down.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. Now, that play was able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
Going for it, and that will be taken in by Ridley for a Falcon touchdown. 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Falcons have taken the lead. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
Extra point up and good by Tavecchio. And that makes the score 14-7. Now after the touchdown, it's Boscher to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. He'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up 2 straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. They've proven that they're going to score. So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up.
Stafford on first down.
Good play, baby.
Take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 15 yards for the Lions there on a first down.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
Now a quick throw as that's complete on the hitch route. The completion good for three and it's second down.
When you decide to run a hitch route, it really helps to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Watch QB jump! Watch QB jump!
Check the middle! 50-50!
To throw again on second down. Stafford will get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. Well, this is how you shake the thoughts of that interception on the last drive and come out and start this one 4-for-4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when and told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row. I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
No, ball comes out. I'm talking about, man. Give it to me.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves them with a 2nd and 3. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A 1-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. The Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line.
And they want it anyway.
Stafford and the Lions now have it 1st and 10 at the 31-yard line.
Sight.
A shotgun snap for Stafford. He's going to walk to him deep left side here. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's 2nd down. It's been this way most of the afternoon, hasn't it? This secondary, it really put this receiving core on lockdown.
Listen, they've worked together like a basketball team that's playing excellent defense, great communication, doesn't matter whether it's man or zone, and especially against deep balls, as we saw there, they're not giving up anything to them.
Back to the air, Stafford on 2nd down. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. 11 yards there, 1st down.
Good route, good pickup for 1st down yardage, and that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot, and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction, then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
Yeah.
Ball on the 42 as they come up 2nd and 10.
Slip. Recon, 132 fighter.
I got you over here.
Stafford gonna give this one off to Johnson. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. It's a pickup of 17 and a 1st down.
They're making it look easy out there. Another 1st down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 1st downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Call it a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. The Clemson Tiger, Vic Beasley, reaches home that time.
Enough takes to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a 3rd and long, and suddenly The momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Throwing on third down, Stafford. Incomplete. It's Jones. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Stafford to Jones, enough for a Lion first down. On first and 10, Stafford. He's got his tight end over the middle, TJ Hockenson. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Johnson. And he's going to be a yard short. Needed 4, but got 3. It would be a very makeable field goal try from here, but instead they're going to go for it. Here we go with Johnson. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. I love those plays. 4th and 1. That's who wants it more this time, the offense.
Yeah, there's a lot of hooting and hollering in there, right? A lot of contact and a lot of collisions as they try and find some space. Who's going to drop their hips, gain leverage, and move the other side backwards? We saw it there for the offense getting it done.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Stafford being chased out left. He was looking for his big tight end there, Jesse James. And that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down. So back-to-back incompletions. 3rd down here and 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range. So now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
Back to throw, Stafford. Got it, he's got it. And the Lions have a touchdown. A 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Extra point good by Prater. And we are tied at 14. So all square here in this 3rd quarter as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone.
Oh, deep in his own territory. Look at them.
And this is scooped up by the Lions. And good field position coming up here. The football at the 12-yard line.
There's never a good place on the field to fumble the ball. Let's just call it as it is.
But definitely not in your own red zone.
In your own red zone, it's heightened, isn't it? Because you're almost automatically giving up a score and the momentum, and everything just changes for your team.
Yeah, so the kickoff fumbled a great field position.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line.
So stupid.
And he's going to be stopped here for no gain. And that's going to take us to the end of the 3rd quarter of play. So they decline it, and they choose to not give them that down back.
And I think that's the key to everything there. They didn't give up any yardage, even on the completed pass. Don't give them an extra down in order to try and pick up a first.
On 3rd down, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Out of the gun, Stafford. And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's 4th down.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Ryan will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10 at their own 21. From the shotgun, Ryan. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. That tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point that continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stop that one for a short game.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
They run. Devontae Freeman. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. Give him 6 yards in the first down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football
Come on.
Players, tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Here's a give to Smith. They'll get only a couple down to the 44.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On third down, Devontae Freeman. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up the fourth down. They'll run for it. It's Freeman. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. Runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. He's back to throw. And he will find Ridley. That's complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The Falcon passing game looking good on this drive as they get the first down.
This defense needs a big play in the worst way because so far they're not putting up much of a fight. If they don't get a stop here soon, this game could be over for them.
And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Let's go, defense. Throwing now is Ryan. The left side completion to Jones. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football, and the Lions have recovered.
Well, that simply is a missed opportunity. They're in position. If they take the ball downfield and score, they've got a chance to win the game. Instead, they cough it up. I don't think next week at practice is going to be a whole lot of fun for him.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Yeah, and when you look at it from the offense's perspective, taking care of the ball is so important. I know they're going to have all kind of ball security drills in practice all next week.
Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10.
Statement after the